The War Manpower Board dictated where you could recruit because wartime, you just couldn't go over to the coast, say, and recruit people from the shipyards at Boeing over there. So a lot of recruitment was done down south because the South wasn't highly industrialized in the 40s. They were given a railroad ticket, and I have to always kind of laugh because the trains came through the Pasco where the railroad station was located about 2 o'clock in the morning. And I'm sure if it had come by during the daylight hours, they wouldn't have bothered to get off the train because the recruiting posters were really funny. Come to the Evergreen State of Washington, sparkling rivers, snow-capped peaks, wonderful fishing and hunting. What do they come to? They come to a desert. At the peak of employment, there were 55,000 people. It was the fourth largest city in the state of Washington. People lived in barracks. The women's barracks was on one side of the camp, surrounded by a barbed wire fence. And because they were recruiting girls right out of high school to come here to work as waitresses, secretaries, clerks, they decided they needed to do something to kind of protect these girls. So they hired a Mrs. Maris. She was Dean of Women at Oregon State College. She organized a lot of things like sororities, scout clubs. She'd organize shopping trips for these women because here they were living out here in the middle of nowhere, and the nearest store of any reasonable thing was 80 miles away. It made life a little bit more tolerable. They built an auditorium. It held 5,000 people. It took 7 days to build this auditorium. Big name bands came here and played. Jimmy Dorsey, Ted Weems, Kay Kaiser played here. And they built a big tavern. At that time, the only thing you could drink in the state of Washington was 3-2 beer, 3.2% alcohol. They opened a brewery over in Walla Walla. Pioneer beer wasn't all that great, but it was beer. At that time, also in the state of Washington, you had to sit down to drink. So people would get off work, rush to the tavern, claim chairs, and then auction their chair off to the highest bidder. Somebody was always trying to make a buck somehow or other. Many people who came here had never received a paycheck before. Their board and room was taken out of their paycheck, and they left here with thousands of dollars of uncashed paychecks. Everything was paid for, essentially, so it was an interesting life.